One, two tacos.
Bourbon.
One barn, two tacos, 800 cocoa great. And cokes.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to our show, Live at the Barn. I'm Jenny. And?
I'm Nick.
And today, we celebrate with a little Irish whiskey.
That's right. This week is St. Patrick's Day,
I've been
not
drinking
St. Paddy's.
All morning. No, people get very angry when people say, I couldn't drink that. I would rather vomit than drink any brown alcohol. But
when you're coming here this weekend, know that we serve West Cork Irish whiskey.
Only the best?
Straight from
what accent
Cork.
Was that?
Yeah, what was that?
Only the best in Irish whiskey. Oh, only the best accents. Yeah. Is that Scottish?
Oh, wow.
Can't. Anyway,
no,
welcome to
Scottish.
Our show.
It wasn't even close.
Oh, welcome. I'm Andy Hopkins here. For St. Patty's Day.
I'm Andy Hopkins.
See, guys, what you don't know is that I'm really, I love doing accents, and
wrong.
I feel really good about them wrong. So sometimes, this week I've been working on a little bit of a British thing, because I can't always do the Irish, so, and who better than Andy Hopkins here? Anyway,
wow.
Nick, I was just, I was just saying to myself, where are the calls for our sponsors?
Yeah, we haven't had a single request since last BARNCAST for sponsors.
We've had one show.
Accepting sponsorships. It
where
really
are they?
It requires nothing. All you have to do is say, we want to sponsor you. Well, we don't need money.
We're going
to. I mean, we need money.
I mean,
we
always need
money,
but like.
Actually, no, we do want their money.
We want some of your money, basically. If you could just send us $9.99 and a self-addressed stamp, we'll send back
something?
An accent. Yeah, but I don't know what's so wrong and why we can't get calls.
You know, and it's a big announcement coming up later in the show.
Yeah.
They're not our sponsor. However, big shout out to Big Elm Brewery.
Huge. We love you guys.
We serve their beer here, and there's a big announcement coming up later in the show.
Yep.
And you're going to be psyched.
Stay tuned for that.
Stay tuned and continue listening to the show through the special announcement and beyond to the end.
Another special guest we have some great guests coming up later, Chris Merenda and Rob Sanzone, local great musicians, and in Picky Masters that's playing this weekend.
That's a live interview.
Live interview, but another special guest for those of you watching, I believe down below, I don't know if the camera can
Murphy.
See little Murphy. We brought the Irish dog.
Come on, get him.
Murphy.
In studio with us today is Murphy the dog.
This is Murphy the dog. He's an Irish Chihuahua.
It's a special
and
breed.
And this is probably the biggest, closest you're going to get to an absolute angel. This
look
is him.
Look at his face.
Look at this dog.
Can you hold him up so his face isn't on the microphone and maybe into the light? Hit your light, Murph.
There we are.
Murph.
Look at this. I want you to really look.
Murph. Oh, Murph.
You've all sinned, but he has not. Okay.
So let's get down to brass tacks here, people.
Yes,
the bottom
definitely.
Line is this is the schedule for the week. Wednesday's open mic as usual. Come on out, everybody.
Yeah, come on out, guys.
You're welcome.
We really want a bunch of different people. You know, we want to see different faces, different musicians. So again, just I encourage you to just keep telling your friends and bring out those musicians and jugglers for our open mic. It's free.
Spoken word, whatever.
Whatever you want to do, acrobatic stance.
This is the safest place to bomb west of the Mississippi.
You're never
going to
find a more precious and comforting spot than this place. And I'm actually, although I sound like I'm joking, I'm not joking. It is a very safe place for open micers, for musicians, artists, what have you, please.
I mean, I don't play open mic very much, but every time I do, I bomb and I feel great about it.
I mean, I never get up for open mic, but what I'm saying to you is it is the safest place you will ever find.
Go
come on
sleep,
down. My little baby.
Oh, daddy boy, the pipes are calling from glen to glen across the mountainside. Oh, daddy boy, the pipes are. So, Thursday night. Doubleheader, local and semi-local musicians.
Great
Andrew
artist,
Victor,
Andrew Victor, singer-songwriter.
And James Hearn.
And then right. Also Friday night, again, I said last week, this is a show you don't want to miss. Elizabeth Ziman of Elizabeth and the Catapult is playing solo. She is the most amazing spirit. She just lights up a room. Her songwriting is beautiful. She's an amazing composer and pianist. I would not miss her at all.
And Irish singer-songwriter Mark
Geary. Oh, my God. Have we mentioned it's St. Patrick's Day this weekend?
Hello.
So please make sure to check out Mark Geary. He's another brilliant singer-songwriter. And the two of them, this is a show you don't want to miss at all. Friday night. Tickets are $15.
Also, Ziman is... Elizabeth Ziman is the lead singer of a band called Elizabeth and the Catapult. She's doing a solo set on Friday night, but it really doesn't matter. She's just
nothing
as good
matters.
Solo as
she could
band,
sing the zip code, and you guys would be in right. awe.
The same zip code?
No, she could sing a zip code, and
like,
it would be
oh, one, two,
like
five,
a bird.
Eight.
Oh, 1213.
Oh, 1-0-0-2-5.
And.
And if you don't know her, look her up, check it out. She's an amazing artist.
Yeah, check
artist.
Everyone
She's
out.
She's written songs for people like Sarah Bareilles and opened up for her and a bunch of other very well-known musicians and artists. She's, right? Or am I talking out of my
No, head? The only reason I gave you a look, let's do this again.
Fucking look.
Just say when you say she's written for or she's opened up for artists like Sarah Bareilles. You said Bareilles. Sarah, can you hear me? I'm just saying.
Sarah Bareilles?
Well, now it all sounds terrible.
Now it sounds ridiculous. What kind of a ridiculous name is that? Bareilles. Come on. All right.
So
that's
and
the
then
Friday show.
Saturday night, again, is going to be a shillelagh shamrock explosion in this room. But seriously, people, the Picky Bastards are such a great band. I encourage you to come out for not only great musicians, great songs, but so much fun. The crowd is going to be insane. I can't wait to see everyone up on the balcony swinging from the trees, but kind of keep it together as well. But this is the show you want to come out and see. It's only $10. Please don't get too drunk and act like a psychopath.
And if you do, then you have to rent a room here instead.
Yes, you must. You must. On the property is the Egremont Village Inn. So you have
a ditch.
Have a shillelagh, fall in a ditch, and then curl your head on a nice pillow in one of our wonderful delectable rooms.
Delectable rooms. All right, and then Sunday's karaoke.
Sunday is karaoke.
But it's St.
Patrick's, Patrick's Day.
So we're going to be singing songs about being Irish.
Oh, God, I love it. I mean, I have like an inkling of Irish in me, but I really feel strongly about it, Nick. I'll tell you.
All right, so in honor of that, let's go to our first clip of the week. Real joy to play this one. This is Danny Boy, played on piano and cello by none other than Sara Keene, my mother, owner of this place.
It's beautiful. We're
and
so happy we have this.
One of our oldest friends in the world, Jerome Carrington, Jerry Carrington, is a world-famous cellist. He was the head cellist at Juilliard for years, taught everybody, played all over the world in symphonies. Here, let's roll the tape, even though it's not tape. Danny Boy with Sara and Jerry.
Love it.
Thank you.
happening. No, but there are so many things happening in that one little clip. So it's very nice that we have that to be able to show.
So shout out to Sarah and Jerry. Shout out to Sarah for
definitely.
You know, sticking through this project.
So we've asked you guys to write in. You can write in anytime. You can DM us on Facebook. Send us a letter. Send us a little ping. What's on your mind?
This is the first letter that we got when we asked. For Dr. Jones.
For Dr. Jones, who's always there to tell you exactly like it is. You have a concern, you have a problem, write in. So this week we hear from Jeff from Saskatchewan. Jeff has a little concern. Dear Dr. Jones, my wife and I have been married 32 years, and I love her, but I just want to add a little spice into our relationship, and I'm not really sure how to go about it.
Dear Jeff, 32 years. My cousin Carmine got less time on a RICO charge. But a story for another time. You say you're looking to spice things up, eh, Jeff? Well, at your age, spice isn't always a good thing. Let's take your particular dish for example. Your dish could decide to spice things up in more ways than one. She could add enough spice so that other diners decide your dish is better than their dish. And when you leave the table for a second to go and shake the cannoli, they may decide to be so bold as to try and stuff your shells with a little spice of their own. Then your dish may decide she likes that recipe better than yours. And that chef could be stirring your dish with a bigger spatula there, Jeff. Another problem that may arise is if you suggest a change in recipe to your dish, you may find that the restaurant closes altogether. So, if you want to continue dining on a regular basis, remember, a bland dish is better than no dish at all. Sincerely, and with all due respect, my friend, and certainly not yours, Dr. Jones.
Great. Thank you, Dr. Jones. I think Jeff's going to sort out his marital problem.
Oh, definitely. Always sort it out here.
Okay. Let's go back to the Friday night show. We're going to play two clips here.
Yeah.
Okay? We're going to play three clips, actually. We're going to play a interview with Elizabeth
Simon.
Yeah,
we did a great interview with Elizabeth back last time she played here.
So we're going to play a little clip from the interview. Then we're going to play a song with her on solo and piano. This is the song, Thank You for Everything, Thank You for Nothing.
Ooh, that is a beautiful, right.
What's
tragic
the story about
song.
That with Sarah Berry? No, who was it? Anne Hathaway?
I believe it was Anne Hathaway who Elizabeth, I forget the entire story. I know that Elizabeth was in a movie with Anne Hathaway playing in one of her songs in a subway station, and I think that Anne discovered Elizabeth and was listening to one of her songs
for... See, that's a loaded word for me when you say it. Sometimes you say it.
Discovered?
Yeah, it's loaded. It means that we would be the first people to have heard her or to give them a mark in the world, and I don't believe that that's
all right,
true.
Well, okay, Nick, you bring up a very good point here, and I'm going to stop using that word loosely.
I feel so vindicated at this
However,
moment.
I believe that the actor Anne Hathaway had heard of the amazing Elizabeth Ziman, and I'm not
she
sure, but she ended
she,
up...
She, that this song that we're about to play, apparently she used it to prep for scenes in Les Mis. I don't know why I asked you to tell the story.
But I do know the scene that she did in Les Mis. I don't know if you saw it, but it is gut-wrenching. Please kill me now. Dying. Nothing can be as bad as that moment. So
perfect for the Irish.
Amazing. Yeah, you're all so... I love the Irish, though. Have I mentioned that? Nick and I would love to get your money
Irish.
To send us on a trip to Ireland because we deserve it. So if you could send in $9.99, please.
I have... So my name is Keane, right? But my actual family name is O'Keegan.
Oh.
Right? Oh. Oh, it's the O'Keegans.
Now, why didn't they just call you Keeg instead of Keen?
Keeg. Nick Keeg.
Oof.
That's a lot of k-k-k.
Might not be here. Might not be here, folks. You know what I'm saying with that?
Right. Actually, the story is my dear father told me was that my great-great-great-great aunt was named Laura Keen. And she had changed her name from O'Keegan when she came over. She was an actress in the Ford Theater, right? And one of John Wilkes Booth's girlfriends.
Oh, my
God.
And
that's how he got in, because he was shagging a bunch of the actresses.
That hussy. If it wasn't for her, we'd still have Abe. Let me just tell.
So she changed the name, but then apparently she was in the paper because of it, in some newspaper, and the rest of the family in Ireland found out and saw it and figured it out and came over and moved in with her.
That's actually an amazing story. But nobody suffered more than the Jews.
Except maybe the Irish. So, clips from Elizabeth Simon. We're going to play an interview. They're going to play a song. And then after that, a song by Mark Geary. Mark's a warm presence and a wonderful
artist. Great guy. We're very happy to have him back.
Let's play the clips.
Okay.
And go.
Great.
I think that my first memory... Well, there's two things. I have a memory, and I'm not sure if it's because my dad has told me the story so much, but supposedly I sang before I spoke. So I was singing. My brother played Suzuki violin, and I was singing like that annoying Twinkle Twinkle Little Stars over and over and over again before I spoke. I was like humming that. So I was like, they knew that I was supposed to do something musical. But my first memory, I think, is playing some piano. There was a laundromat around the corner that had like an acrosonic piano, and I just went there with my mom when she did the laundry, and I would fool around on the piano, and I just remember playing Heart and Soul probably pretty badly. I know that my father's his attention to detail and prose in writing something meaningful has pushed me to pay more attention to my lyrics than to my music. Mm-hmm. Always write lyrics first. And to always make sure that I can stand by what I'm singing. So I think that's been very helpful in what I do. If I look at my stuff on paper, like I do a lot of writing for other bigger artists. I've collaborated with some pretty amazing people.
Yeah.
I'm not like going to start name dropping now, but I've been lucky enough to work with some amazing people. And even now, and Sara Bareilles had me open for her at Madison Square Garden. I mean, it doesn't get better than that. You know, I've done really fun, wonderful things. I did Carnegie Hall. Like, I feel like I've done a lot of things that I can look back on in my life when I die and be like, that was a really fun moment. That was great. But it doesn't really equate to necessarily like selling CDs or, you know, really making money on the road. And I don't really expect those things. I think some people get burnt really easily, and when they don't like see like a easy life ahead, they realize that, you know, whether they get married or they have kids or they want to put their kids through college or do all these normal things. And I think that there's a sacrifice in my life because I don't expect those things for myself. What I expect for myself is that I know I'm addicted to music, and I know I can't stop writing, and I know I can't stop playing, and it's what gives me, you know, it's what makes me wake up in the morning. Mm-hmm. So that's why I still do it, and that's why I think I'll do it forever as long as I'm alive. But it's, you know, unfortunately, it has nothing to do with a livelihood. I do some film scoring on the side, and I make some money doing that, and I do a lot of like odds and end things. But really, I'm like a songwriter that gets by.
That has
fans.
Thank you for everything, and thank you for nothing, my brother. There's no in between, never one without the other. I may not know anything, but I think I want something. For every door opening, there's another one slowly closing in. Oh, thank you for loving me, and thank you for leaving. Oh, thank you for promising, and then promptly forgetting. Oh, for the gifts that were given, just to be taken for granted. Studied indifference, cat turned to careless, once disenchanted. For the glass there's filled, and then just as easily broken. Oh, thank you for everything, and thank you for nothing. Oh, Thank you for trusting me, then biting the bullet. Thank you for laughing out loud, even when you don't mean it. They say hurting is growing, if you believe when you say it. So I'll just keep saying it. Thank you, thank you. I'll just keep saying it. Thank you, thank you. I'll just keep saying it. I'll just keep saying it. Thank you, thank you. Thank you for everything, my brother. Thank you for nothing at all. La, la, la.
Very intense German man came up to me after the gig and said, Mark, that show was okay. And I said, well, thank you. He said, what is it with the Irish and the sad songs? What's going on with yous? I said, well, it's the water or the history. I said, well, you know, not all our songs are sad. Some of them are certainly sad. I said, I have a song called Happy. He said, yes, that was the most depressing one. So, Ellen, this is for you. We are one voice talking with the veil pulled back. We are wise, we don't know. We are two wings broken with a veil that's cracked. We are candlelit and low. In our light and in our dark, in our nights, storm clouds come and they crack. Body blows at the back. God knows why I think that. Come back. Ooh, 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 ooh. We are two wings eclipsing all the love we keep. We are wolves against the snow. We are two wound watches on your wrist. You said one is fast, one won't go. In our heart,
been alive, been a die, been alive. Storm clouds coming, they crack. Body blows at the back. Black eye, how'd you get there? You're not up too much in the sack. God knows why I think that. Come back.
Wait, wait. What's that I hear, Nick?
Is it time again?
It's time for the Moss Report. Each week, we go out in the field and discuss life, or what have you, with our dear Slink Moss. Take it away.
Hi, everybody. This is the Moss Report for Monday, May 11th. It's 46 degrees, and I'm in Hudson, New York on Green Street. I'm parked outside of Casa Latina, and I'm looking forward to breaking my fast. I'm on a intermittent fasting diet, which means that I fast for 16 hours and then eat within an 8-hour period. It's going pretty good. I can tell you that I feel very much more alert now and clear-headed, so I'm doing the Moss Report with a very clear head. Except for this daylight savings time BS, which I just don't understand, which has thrown my body clock off a little bit. But it's okay, I've got Sam Cooke on, and let's listen to. Dude, had delicious lunch of a big bowl of soup and a steak and cheese pupusa, which is like a handmade tortilla stuffed with stuff. And there was like a side of sauerkraut with peppers in it. And it was a pretty spicy meal, but I had a lemonade to wash it down with. And now I'm here parked in the Walmart parking lot outside of Hudson, New York. There's views of the Catskill Mountains. It's beautiful. The wind is blowing, but the sun is out, and I still got the Sam Cooke rolling here. Sounding great. Have a good one. This has been the Moss Report. Bye.
Boy, I'm glad that fast is working out for Slink.
Oh, man, I love that guy.
What is it, intermittent fasting? I should try that.
We all should. I think you're actually supposed to fast once a day. I mean... once every other day?
I try to practice intermittent sobriety, but it didn't work out very well.
As you see, it's not going very well.
They're going to play us a song to start it off.
She swore that she
So we're here with Rob Sanzone and Chris Merenda of the Piggy Bastards. Guys, thanks for coming down.
Thanks for having us.
And we're big show this Saturday night. We did last year, St. Patrick's Day. We're doing it again a day early. We're psyched.
Yeah.
Yes.
St. Patrick's Day Eve.
And why don't you tell the people about, let's see, my gummy, this.
Yeah, very special release.
Very special.
You guys want to talk about
it? We brought a little piece of last year's St. Patrick's Day show with us, which we will have at the show this Saturday. It's a live recording from the barn, St. Patrick's Day. Lots of great St. Paddy's Day themed music and other. In the column of other.
Yeah.
Themed on other topics.
Yes. St. Patrick's Day. And other. Blue
yes.
Checkbox.
I think this is the first. You're going to be selling them so people bring some cash money?
This is the official release date of our
That's
debut
great.
Record.
That's fantastic.
Yeah,
that
excited.
Makes me very happy. That's also the first live recording from the barn that's
yeah.
going to be for sale.
Yeah.
Yeah, Earth. That's huge.
It's huge.
That's amazing. And there was another piece of info regarding the other
beer.
Special.
Oh yeah,
beer.
We have a yeah. special announcement to make that we've been collaborating with Big Elm Brewery, which is our local amazing beer makers. And we've collaborated on a special edition session IPA called Picky Bastards Pickin' Session Ale.
Whoop.
And, I mean, it's really
yeah,
cool.
It's our first
it's
beer.
Great.
Oh man, I wish we could show you the
right
the
now.
Beer label. Actually, it kind of looks like the CD, but it's on a beer can.
Audio and video.
Has there ever been a band that's even like a
had
big
a
band? Yeah, like even huge bands. I mean, sponsors, sure, but not actually
I'm
called.
Gonna say no.
I'm gonna say no.
I'd say this is a
this
a,
is the biggest
preferred.
Ever, right?
Like the Stones
I mean,
don't have a beer.
They don't know,
right?
They don't
I mean,
here.
Bill
Iron
Cosby
Star,
had Jell-O, and,
yeah.
and we know what happened there.
I would have
so.
Settled for a Jell-O or a soda.
I'm going to pass on the Jell-O.
Yeah,
Mickey
let's...
Bastards flavored Jell-O.
You're right.
Yeah.
What it
forget,
like. The kids love it.
Forget the Jell-O. I'm happy
but
we have a beer.
But speaking of that, this is something I've been wanting to ask Rob for a really long time. I don't know if
oh,
anyone's
yeah.
ever approached you on this. But what have you thought about Rob Sanzone's Calzones?
It's,
yes.
You know,
I've been wondering that too.
This is,
I mean,
this
is
funny you asked that
has
question.
Has to be done.
This has been a sort of a back burner backup career plan for me.
Right.
Was if the music didn't ever pan out, it was going to be Sanzone's Calzones.
Right.
Really? Can I take your order? Yeah.
Sanzone's Calzones.
Sanzone's Calzones. Calzones only.
Do you see yourself as like a hands-on owner-operator situation
or like
in this?
In the
yeah,
actual...
I think I'd be making the calzones
yeah.
one at a time and then right. individually delivering them on a moped so that they
really
it's like
this.
You know, it's a maker thing where like you get the whole experience
it's
from
like
one
$100 per calzone.
So it'd be like a 30-hour or less delivery rate, but
that's like Peking Duck
for
right.
the day
yeah.
before
yeah.
you get it delivered.
That's right.
And where does having a beer, where does that rate on huge you know, record contract, national tour,
beer.
Or beer, which is a beer named after your own
it's
beer.
It's kind of the top.
I kind of, for me personally, I would put it on the top for me.
Yeah, I think so.
All right,
yeah.
We've made it, buddy.
We've made
yeah,
it.
They're here.
Pickies
wow.
have made it.
This is exciting.
Right. Our own beer.
I've been meaning to ask you, I was looking at a tape of the show from last year, last night, prepping this, and I don't understand how you play that, because...
The claw hammer.
No, but it's like, are these fingers even...
Yeah, it's unbelievable.
No, it's just it's a claw.
Wow.
As you can see, it's like a
the
C.
The claw!
The claw! The claw! So you get your claw... I'm very adamant when I teach a lesson. You don't
yeah.
want to pluck. It's not like a guitar where you're plucking or like the bluegrass style, scrug style.
Yeah.
The claw hammers.
Wow.
And that is
wow.
the... That's the official way to play?
Well, no, it's not the official
the
way
official
to play.
Yeah, but so what is that called aside from the claw? Or it's just
frailing.
A different
Some people call it frailing.
That's right.
Okay.
I call it claw hammering.
I like that.
I like it. Is there a new instrument you're going to start in on, either one of you? You're picking up something new?
I've been playing a little more dobro. I've been really woodshedding on the mandolin a lot, and I've been mandolin shopping, looking for other models and stuff. But yeah, kind of focusing on those two, mandolin and dobro for me.
Yeah, you don't want to hear me play the fiddle, so.
Really?
I kind of do, though.
Now that you mention it.
At all?
I can play like Joli Blanc. It's a nice Cajun piece. But I sound like I'm, you know, in kindergarten.
Right.
You'd be like, oh, that's so cute.
Like Suzuki kindergarten with the box. You ever do Suzuki with that
Not
box?
Not like I've a prodigy what's kindergartner.
It's like a method they teach kids. They give them a fucking box instead of an instrument and tell them to play that.
First you play the box.
Yeah, first you play and a box.
First time we met could have been just in Great Barrington. Like we're putting up posters for our other bands. Like, hey, man, I got this show going on.
Oh, I like this story. Oh,
yeah, I got this show going on too, man. That's cool.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, man, you play music? That's sweet. Cool, man.
How long ago have you been playing? I mean, how long have you been playing together?
Playing together? Well, probably 7 years.
Yeah.
Six, 7 years, something like that. 6 years?
Yep.
I don't remember. Probably about seven.
What's the absolute, like, most demoralizing moment from that 7 years of playing together? Like, the nadir.
The most demoralizing shit ever was.
I could tell you, like,
I got one. Some of my, we should mention it on air.
Right. Okay, I'll let you do that after this brief story.
Okay.
Some of my favorite moments in the past 7 years are when Rob catches the audience, like, asleep.
Right.
You know, like, a song will end and, like, nobody will clap. He usually has some of the most brilliant insults available.
Oh, I need one.
Like the title of our album, Tired and Sorry. Yeah. We were trying to get the audience to sing along, and they were not with us, so Rob called them Tired and Sorry. And there you have it, you know? There so some is. Of my
I feel
favorite
like that
moments.
Every day.
I do.
Don't you?
Tired
we usually feel tired, and
right?
I'm usually sorry about something,
waking.
So, yeah.
Right.
Yeah, that's great.
That's a good one. That's
life's
good.
About mastering your regrets. That's not angry, just bitter.
That's true.
Right. What was your story?
Yeah.
Boy, we got the opportunity to play for a, I won't say where, show one time, and it was billed as an opportunity for us. And we were told we couldn't bring amplification because of where we were going to be set up.
Right.
And it was, you know, it was sort of a, it was going to be a lot of exposure. We were excited. And it ended up being us playing on a sidewalk outside of the front door for this venue that was hosting a larger show.
And so, like exposed to the elements.
And we weren't
exposed to the elements.
To like,
and people were walking by, kind of looking at us like, are they supposed to be here?
We can't even hear those guys.
So we couldn't, and as we were finishing up our opportunity of big exposure, there was another band setting up across the other side of the sidewalk with a huge PA system. That was for me.
Wow.
Right. All we wanted was a plug. We just
wanted a little electricity.
Maybe just two prongs.
Just just a little.
110.
115.
Yes. Wow, that's too bad.
It wasn't really horrible, but it was kind of funny.
I know what you mean. I'm with you, though. I felt a little degraded.
Yeah.
But that's an external circumstance.
That's
good.
True.
If that's the
that's
most
true.
Degrading thing, it wasn't like.
It's not terrible.
Yeah.
What's
now
the
we
best?
We have our own beer.
Right.
So.
Yeah, is that the best? Is the beer the best?
Right, I think it was, you know, I shouted out, like, someday I'm going to have my own beer, man. And I'm going to come back here with a PA system.
You
should. Pretty sure you did shout that.
My beer.
Wait, you should go
and
back
we have a
with
a
beer.
We have a CD here.
This is ridiculous.
We've got a beer.
I love that we have a CD in 2019.
We're at the bar.
Like, yeah, I know. No, it works.
You'll be wanting the CD. You can't fall down and break it.
Yeah, this is like fantastic. A second home for us here at the barn, you know.
We love beautiful. You guys.
We love you too.
Yeah, and also anybody out there who's listening, if anybody's listening and you haven't been to a Picky Shows, you
yeah, do yourself a favor
come.
And get down. It's an experience. Not only are these guys incredible musicians, they're great showmen, but the audience always the entire room, it's just one of those shows at the barn, and we have a bunch of shows like that, but these guys really bring a whole room together, and it's a pretty exciting vibe.
Oh, so you guys choose a lot of great material to cover, but you elevate the material when you play.
Yeah, the songs are, it's not just, oh, we're doing this song by so-and-so. You make it your own, and it's almost like a completely different song,
it's
the
rare.
Cover songs.
It's
and
like your version of the song as opposed to a cover of the song. It's a big difference.
Yeah.
I mean, we hear a lot of covers in here, but that's not the case when you guys play, which is...
It's wonderful. And you're wonderful men.
Right?
You are wonderful men, guys.
There's alcohol involved, too.
Yeah, be careful this Saturday.
Anybody
people
want to do a shot?
That's right.
Right now?
Please drive safely.
Afternoon. Oh wait, you gotta figure out.
Afternoon
show.
Yep. Yeah.
No drinking.
But at the show, we're staying here right on site.
Oh right, yeah, this could get crazy.
Distance. Yep.
Shamrock That's Central. Are you guys? Who's Irish? Wait, do you have Irish?
Not
Italian?
Officially that we know of, but I think somewhere. At some point,
I know it's funny. We're like Italians, like
right.
You're,
yeah.
Merenda means light lunch or snack in Italian.
Oh my God!
Which that's the story of my life.
That's amazing. That really? You like, know, we named a taco after you.
I know.
Really? That's, you got a taco see? Named after you too? You got a beer and a taco.
Well, right? Once I get a salad, I can put.
We have. And people always try.
You guys could do the calzone. Yeah, that'd be good.
I need.
Well, yeah. Let's.
This could
we'll
be
put that in.
Be on the winter menu. You know.
Yeah.
Lots of cheese.
What would be in it?
The Sanzone calzone? Ooh, like, I don't know if I can answer that right now.
God, that's, I really have been wanting to talk about
like
this.
Broccoli would be good.
Broccoli
and maybe chicken, garlic, jalapeno, broccoli.
That sounds really good. I probably couldn't eat that myself,
that
but
night.
Amazing.
I can feel it now resting like a lump, a bolus, if you will. Did you know that's a word?
Bolus.
That's the chunk of food that you chew as it goes down. It's called a bolus.
Is that true?
Really? That's gonna be the name of my next metal.
And
band.
Sometimes
bolus.
Yeah.
That's good.
Bolus. Wait, that's amazing.
Bolus. Bolus.
What's right.
What's in the future?
Yeah. What's in the future?
What's in store that we should know about? The beer.
Speaking of the barn and the two of us, Rob Sanzone, Chris Merenda. We will be playing in a Led Zeppelin band.
Oh, God. That's another amazing.
Coming up at the end of this month.
29th.
March 29th. Right.
That's right. I'm going to get our
These guys, if you haven't checked that out, man. Again, come down for that because it's just not your normal tribute show.
Yeah.
It goes beyond.
Four Sticks is the name of that project.
Yeah, we love it.
It's.
I mean, people go crazy for it.
Than that, it's a.
What? Which.
I mean, tribute doesn't work.
I know
it's
Super Bowl.
It minimizes
honorarium.
It. I'm gonna say Super Bowl.
Yeah, it's the Super Bowl.
Right, it's true. Like it's Super Bowl esque.
It is though. It is. See, woo. I mean,
right, Murphy likes it.
All right.
All right.
Else?
So, any last minute? Okay, so this Saturday, these guys are playing. It's gonna be amazing. Get tickets now. Or at the door Saturday
take
night.
Your chances at selling the door,
it's but it's quick. Probably gonna sell out.
It is. Sell.
I mean,
fans,
it is.
Right? A lot of fans come back or post the night we've been playing here, being like, oh, "I wish I could have gotten in. I got there."
Really?
Yeah. A lot of people are like, "Oh, you know, we didn't get there in time. We'll be there the next one." And
that's what I well, like to hear.
Yeah. There's a
come on down.
There's a love for right? the picky bastards.
Oh yeah,
and, you know,
we know.
We're the picky bastards, but we're not. Too picky. We're not too stuck up and snobby.
We're not,
I mean,
not choosy.
At
we,
all.
We like 5 to 10% of the people we come across.
Yeah.
It's true.
just to be
us
clear,
too.
it's a double entendre, right? Because you pick your guitars and instruments.
Exactly.
Right.
Yes, thanks, Nick.
It's not.
Very
just
good.
Be clear
just so you guys know.
Double entendre.
Entendre.
Let grasses grow and water slow in a free and easy way. But give me enough for the railroad stuff that's been near Galway Bay. Come gangers all from Donegal, Sligo and Lake Shore too. We'll give him a slip and take a sip on a rare old mountain dew. Hi diddly 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 dum, for the diddly diddly dum, diddly dum, diddly 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 I the diddle daddy dum for the diddle yum dum diddle yum day diddle yum day. I the diddle daddy dum for the diddle yum dum diddle yum day diddle yum day.
That was great.
Thanks.
Love you guys. Thank you.
Woo-hoo.
Ready? All right, everyone. Nick and I have a segment that we like to do every week. Well, second time. Called Pro Not Pro. And
we're doing this all the time anyway. Whether we
we do this in our daily life. This is how we
it's like a philosophy.
Connect.
You
it is a philosophy.
Sometimes you got to lay where the rubber meets the road.
Yeah.
Are you in or are you out?
Are you pro or are you not pro?
Pro?
This week it came up in passing. Some people think the end of the world is near. And we see a lot of that in our day-to-day life. Anyway, people think it's going to happen in 12 years. Are we pro or not pro about the end of the world coming? Nick?
Not pro.
I'm going to go out on a limb here, folks. I'm going to say I'm pro.
You're pro the end of the world in 12 years. I want to hear what
I know this sounds
about.
Crazy because I really love life, and I'm not a dark person.
You're making Murphy happy.
Murphy's choking on the side. Murphy, you okay? I'm not even a dark person, and I know it's crazy to say that I'm pro the end of the world, but there are things that, I mean, I gotta say, week after week, it's kind of like, oh, I won't have to post online anymore. I mean, how much can we really go around with the months year after year? We're in March and then April, and then we get to the end of the year, and we gotta do it again, and we gotta be like, zip, zip, I'm ready for life. I'm exhausted. You know, and I love my partner.
This is an amazing amount of nihilism we're seeing.
I love my friends. I want to stand up about how much I love life. However, there's a lot to deal with. If we could all go together at peace, just all go together like a silent auction. I mean, like a silent ending.
Well, no, you're assuming that the end of the world is going to be sort of like a peaceful Jim Jones kind of deal.
No, not Jim Jones.
Well,
I don't want
it once.
I just want us to, you know, we all go to sleep that night and then we go.
Well,
like
that
an easy
nice, like the end of the Notebook.
The end of the Notebook, kind of the way my mother went. Oh my God, we watched the Notebook.
Died
my mother died a couple months ago. Well, anyway, she got it easy. Not easy for me, but she slipped away into wherever you
that
go.
That sounds great.
No
the
suffering.
Rainbow Bridge.
She went to the Rainbow Bridge.
So you're saying that if there was a giant Rainbow Bridge for all of humanity to cross hand in hand in perfect harmony, like to buy the world.
Yeah,
the
we like to buy. Yeah, and we have a little glow in our cheeks and we feel fresh and we've, you know, signed off on any troubles we've had in life. We've said it's okay what we've done, and we've all been forgiven, and we're just going to go into the marigold field. And
so you're pro, but with provisional needs.
Yeah, I'm pro, but I want it to go exactly the way I want it to go. But I think
and
that
I'm
it. A lot of us are tired, Nick.
Well, I'm tired too. I'm the most tired of anybody.
You
but
know,
I'll tell
like
you why I'm not pro. I'm not pro because I am going to relish being a cranky old man.
Oh. Mm.
I'm finger pulling. I'm talking about telling
going
people.
To be. do, 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 do.
I'm going to relish being old.
Right.
I mean, I can't get any more decrepit than I already am, so that's off the table.
That's true.
I'm hunched. Look at me. I'm hunched like this.
Yeah.
I look like I'm 80 already.
He doesn't. He's being silly.
I'm really not. I mean, look at this beard.
The beard goes, it's like he's 12 years old. That, so don't even fall for this. I'm the one that got a back denture this week that doesn't even fit.
It really doesn't.
Do you know what it's like to actually hear the news that you need a denture? I'm not even 50 years old. Today, I got an AARP. They want to know why I didn't sign up to be a member yet. I'm not even 50 years old.
You're pro the end of the world?
Well, kind of.
All right, well, I'm not pro, not just because of the finger pulling, because I love life. And only do I live life for me. I want other people to have life.
I know. I do too.
Look at all the little teen babies. You going to take that away from them? They're going to get to 12. Every baby born just today.
Oh, God, I'm sorry.
Only going to make it
to 12. I know. I don't like the idea of that.
They're going to get their first pimple, and then they're going to die in a fiery flame.
And all the puppies and kittens that are being born this week. Well, 12, that's about all they got.
That's about how long Murphy's got left.
Yeah. I don't want violence, and I don't, you know, I just want a little peace, I guess. And if we could all go together whenever it happens, it would be a nice way. Like, I don't want to end up like in one of those movies where there's dust and you're walking through dust, and then you go into a supermarket and there's like dusty cans, and then there's one dog that's following you around. Like, I don't want to be that person.
It sounds like my life today.
I know.
All right, so to summarize, a peaceful end of the world in 12 years where we all die.
A peaceful exit, like an exit interview.
Exit. Is that what it is, though?
An interview with yourself upon exiting.
She's going way out there today, guys.
Yes. Stay tuned. If you'd like to talk about this further, please DM me. I just like saying that. Give me a
what
DM.
What is a DM?
Direct message. Direct message.
It's a BM.
Yeah, BM me on the side.
Yeah, you'll be wanting the CD. You can't fall down and break it.
Oh.
All right, well, let's hop forward to next week.
next week.
We're going to have a little window into next week's entertainment.
Next week's entertainment. We've got, Thursday, March 21st. Is that right?
Oh, boy, I'm excited.
Gregory Stovetop.
Stovetop,
I'm staying for this one.
Oh, right. Stovetop stuffing.
Oh, this guy's great. Gregory Stovetop is a unique artist. You want to come down and see him. He's like a wild Spitfire. Wild mountain, really rocking guy,
Grizzly Adams and Rick Springfield mixed.
Yeah, with like a little bit of David Lee Roth, maybe. Great performer. Please come and check him out. We discovered him recently.
See, there you go again.
He's amazing.
We didn't discover Gregory Stovetop.
Okay, I heard about Gregory Stovetop. I understand what you're saying.
Yeah.
I understand. I heard about him and I loved him. Friday night is comedy. It's a special comedy show, this one. The show is called, brought to you by, The Barn presents Women of a Certain Age Comedy. And Carol Montgomery, who is a comic, is taking the show on the road. She is a excellent comedian, has great women on the show, pro-women comedians, and her show actually is premiering Saturday night on Showtime Television.
Saturday?
It's kind of a big deal. Next Saturday, the 23rd, the night after her show here.
That's crazy.
So that's kind of crazy. So check that out, because she is going to be
big.
And next Saturday is another amazing artist, Emily Muir.
Oh.
This will be Emily's third time back at the barn. She's coming back with an opener, Matthew Susich. He's great. He opened for her last time. They're beautiful music, beautiful songs, beautiful songwriting. Emily Muir plays a lot, actually, with Elizabeth and the Catapult, too. They're friends. Great, great artists. Very happy to have them here.
Groovy. So let's roll a clip from Stovetop to introduce some people to his music.
Yeah,
roll the clip.
This is great.
Oh, pretty heartbreaker, is this all you got? The weight of your eyes, holding down your smile, into your lips a skin sacrifice. I don't even want to know the price. With flames so high, to black the sky, nap on dry, with flames so high to black the sky, and drink the nap on dry. Is this all you got? Pretty hard record. Walking out the mile, whatever's left between my chest is satisfied. Can't wait for you to break me with your hand. Oh, I don't even wanna know your plan. Oh, with flames so high to black the sky and drink the nap on track. Oh, with flames so high, and drink the nap on track. Oh, give it all you got. Watch your finger fall heavy on the edge of a lip. Gonna tease the intuition, again the apparition. Going creeper to the corner, bring the lights up in the distance. Never ever let it catch you, tie a noose around your neighbor. You're not in a position to deflect the ammunition. Seven nerves and never let the morning light deliver. While you're shipwrecked, blood killed and heartbroken, love filled. Barbecue the knife, fire, tangle.
barbed wire. It's too late for you to stay. If it takes a heart to break for you to see who I am, suffering to understand. I've always been a tourist in my hometown. Sweetest and teeth to treat, stopping to feed a thief. Tangled in a stranglehold from opening the door below. Have it still hanging in, stretched outside. Bar-fed hopelessness, make believe it's Christmas. Hold tight the triple knots, the face you lighted by a lap. Bear beside you, name carved and curse, a letter seems to fold and stitch together. Intention implemented by reflecting imperfection. Press the heart's accelerator, lift it like an elevator. Walk like a warrior through fire and stone. As well it be the hopeful sea and split and waste of wandering. Soul to spill on a heart be like a mountain range. And I traded love for everything that loneliness or sugar can hide. You would bow forever, extended vacation, deny the denier, honey. Off the pavement, that's what they all say. Notify the other guy, takes one to know one. You loyal mosquito, skip another sand out and tell me what the future holds. Lightning quick matchstick, falsetto magnet. We only know what we live from. It falls from the limb, roots and twine, fruit of bears. Climb on what's left behind, cornerstone run around. Kingdom built to burn it down, fortress the freedom bell. Smacked by an angel, spiraling straight to hell. What does it really mean? Hell, I'm dealing in dimensions. The sunlight's collapsing, scratching to a map. Stretching to a pretzel, sliding through the bottle glass of quick luck cocktails, coned at the campfire, little more than less. Cactus in my sweatpants, blaming all the lake effect of dust. 4 4 mile, Walsh Lake, Murder Mount, Jesus Hill, and Parker Rob, racist turnaround, rap bone, bear flex, breaking you bad. Hospital trail, launch rap, bunny hop, swamp rat, midnight madness. We tore up the whole town, held up the gas pump, first went out of the in crowd, tattooed in moonlight, tangled in trumpet vine. From a tightrope cause I didn't cut my toenails, and pages of the ages collided and ripped up the force-fed horse pill, buckshot bullshit, last summer false prophet, foolhardy wrist rocket, match made in heaven, mother God, I don't buy it. And I traded love for everything that loneliness or sugar can hide. And I traded love for so high to block the sky and drink the nap on dry. With flames so high to block the sky and drink the nap on dry. Oh, is this all you
song?
Oh God, well, aside from Danny Boy, which is just so touching, I'm gonna say the Unicorn Song. This is a great one. I think it's the Irish Rovers. It's this little song, my mother used to play it, she got it on 45, she used to buy 45s, which was great. And it's the sweetest little song about Noah's Ark and all the animals hopping on. But not that little unicorn. He got left behind, which is why he might not be around. Not that he does exist in our hearts. But this is a very, very sweet, touching song.
A long time ago when the earth was green, and there was more kinds of animals than you'd ever seen, they'd run around free. The earth was being born, but the loveliest of them all was the unicorn. There was green alligators and long-necked geese, some humpty back camels and some chimpanzees, some cats and rats and elephants, but sure as you're born, the loveliest of all was the unicorn. Now God seen some sinning, and it gave him pain. And he says, stand back, I'm going to make it rain. He says, hey, Brother Noah, I'll tell you what to do. Build me a floating zoo. and take some of them green alligators and long-necked geese, some humpty backcamas and some chimpanzees, some cats and rats and elephants, but sure as you're born, don't you forget my unicorn. Old Noel was there to answer the call. He finished up making the ark just as the rain started falling. He marched in the animals two by two, and he called out as they went through, "Hey Lord, I got you green alligators and long-necked geese, some humpty-backed camels and some chimpanzees, some cats and rats and elephants, but Lord, I'm so forlorn, I just can't see no unicorn." Then Noah looked out through the driving rain. Them unicorns were hiding, playing silly games, kicking and splashing while the rain was pouring. Oh, them silly unicorns. Green alligators and long-necked geese, some humpty-backed camels and some chimpanzees. Noah cried, "Close the door, 'cause the rain is pouring, and we just can't wait for no unicorn." The ark started moving, it drifted with the tide. Them unicorns looked up from the rocks and they cried, and the waters came down and sort of floated them away. And that's why you never seen a unicorn to this very day. You'll see green alligators and long-necked geese, some humpty-backed camels and some chimpanzees, some cats and rats and elephants, but sure as you're born, you're never gonna